But basically, the government is expecting people to wait longer for less of a pension. And actually, public sector workers see that as being unfair. Because they've taken the job on the basis of, like, that is part of the reward package for having that particular job. People aren't saying that they should be, people don't expect to be fantastically paid, but they see that as one of the benefits of like actually being working in the public sector is the pensions. Otherwise, many people would have chose to do something different if they realised that there was going to be no long-term benefits. Many people would be like myself, where actually they've chosen not to go into other careers that are better paid on, you know, in the short term, but have actually thought about the long term and about what, you know, what happens in the future.
If this goes on as it is, then they'll find that large numbers of teachers leave teaching and younger people won't come into teaching, because this has been a fundamental part of the setup for teachers for a very long time. We've always negotiated with government before. This government's trying to impose changes without negotiation.
The unions can only get stronger, because what we have to, what we're doing at this moment is other unions are gathering with these unions. PCS, N.U.T, U.C.U are all out today. We anticipate other unions joining us in the autumn. There's no doubt about it that public sector trade unionists are not prepared to accept what the government is doing in terms of our conditions of pay, our pensions, and what they're doing to the services that we work in.
Give up, brother.
Stop! 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 Stop!
No whips! No bumps! No public sector
bumps! I know, yeah, I knew everyone says that.
What they're claiming is completely untrue. Our pension schemes are affordable and they are sustainable, and they want the money to take to pay for the greed of the bankers, and that's why what they're doing is wrong.
All the rights that people have fought for over the years are one by one being rolled back. I have a daughter at university who's now getting heavily into debt. I got a grant to go to university. Free education, a basic right, is gone. free health for all has gone. It's just taking away every foundation of what makes a society work. And then they'll turn around and go, why did it all break down?
The N.U.T think this strike today is necessary because the government doesn't seem to be listening, and our pension fund, teachers' pension fund, has been proven to not cost any money, and the government's saying that it is costing money. It just seems to be the government to lie.
A teacher's pension will be £10,000 per annum, which is below the subsistence allowance. So some of us are going to have worked for 20 odd years, paid in our dues to pensions and taxes, and we're going to end up on a subsistence allowance. And it's going to really impact on recruitment to new graduates. Graduates are not going to come into the teaching profession. We don't do it for the money, we do it to make a difference to the youth of today.